the old Securities Commission, now called the Financial and Consumer Affairs Authority as well. And you'll find if you set up a co-op that once you get $100,000 of share investment, you're obligated to deal with the Securities Commission, as one should have to in Saskatchewan. So this is to protect the investor, protect your shareholders. So the Securities Commission essentially scrutinizes your application. And when it approves your share offering, it'll do so on the understanding that you follow the commitments that you made in your application with the Securities Commission. So you have to prepare good financial statements with detailed notes. You have to support the projections you're making on projected return on investment. You obviously have to demonstrate that you're wisely investing in this case, in solar assets. There's all kinds of hurdles that your board will need to clear if it's applying to the Securities Commission. That protects your shareholders, but it also requires you to have some members of your board who've got the patience and the skills to be able to put together an application that will pass the hurdle of the Securities Commission, because you'll be held to a fairly high standard in terms of accounting practices and in terms of planning for your projects and in terms of your revenue projections. The other limitation of this, and so this is one of the things you'll want to think about as you decide what model you want to go with, is that we can only sell shares and therefore only sell membership during periods when the Securities Commission allows us to raise money. And there are times when you can start and deadlines when you can stop. We basically be selling shares in a window of 3 to 4 months each time. And so what that means is that when, you know, for instance, our last share offering closed at the end of July, so that means that since then we haven't been able to sell any new membership. If we weren't using this model, if we were, say, using a not-for-profit model, just as an example, we wouldn't face that restriction. We'd be able to sell memberships at all times. Another option that you might want to look at is Ottawa has a solar co-op. It's called OREC, the Ottawa Renewable Energy Co-op, but it's just involved in solar. And you can join and be a member without holding preferred shares. And so that opens the door to more membership, but it also means you've got a lot of members that don't really have a big stake in the organization in terms of investment. And so those are all different models that you can look at. Ottawa's been going for a long time now. They obviously have the benefit of the feed-in tariff in Ontario. But they just did a share offering. This is after many, many years of being part of the community. But they just did a share offering for $1.7 million. So our last share offering that we just completed, we raised about $300,000. So we've got some money to invest now in. We've both covered the cost of the installations we've done, and we've got money for probably 3 new installations. So we're happy with where we're at this stage, and we're basically spending the winter planning, looking for new building partners, and planning new solar installations with them. You can go to the next slide. And I just that we're almost done the presentation, I just wanted to give you a sense for a couple of other things to think about. One is that we approached the Canadian Worker Cooperative Federation and became a member of the Federation. And one of the options that they offer is for people to be able to invest in a cooperative and get an RSP investment, basically, on their preferred share. So a handful of our members have done this and are quite happy with it. And of course, that gives them an immediate tax credit. This really only works for your bigger investors. There's a $50 a year fee associated with managing an RSP through the Canadian Worker Cooperative Federation, which is a perfectly reasonable charge. So you can only invest in $1,000, then you're paying $50 a year on it. You can see that the economics don't really add up over the long term. Whereas if you've got $10,000 in, then it starts to make more sense. So some of our members have used this, and it's basically been our bigger shareholders that have done this. The next slide, Josh. So we've got an 11-member board. Two of our members are appointed by the Saskatchewan Environmental Society, but the society recognized that the co-op was going to become an entity separate from the society, which it is, and that it should really be run by its members. So 9 of the 11 board members are elected by the 168 members in the cooperative. And we've also got an advisory committee, and I recommend this model if you do set up a co-op and have your own volunteer board. Having some advisory committee members who've got legal expertise, engineering expertise, marketing expertise, very, very helpful. We've had a great advisory committee. They've been super. And some of them have got a lot of business experience too. Like they have the former CEO of SED Systems in Saskatoon is on our advisory committee, for instance. We've got one of the best lawyers in Saskatoon on the advisory committee. This is very helpful. And we can go maybe to the next slide. So this is just our website if you want to check it out. But you don't need the detailed website. Just plug in SES, so it'll go up and it'll come up. And if we can offer more support to your co-op if you decide to go down this road, we'd be really happy to do that. So please feel very welcome to contact me or other members of the board, depending on our expertise. I'm really excited that you're looking at this in a serious way. I'd be very happy to answer any questions that you might have. I'm hoping about the ones that have already been asked. Yes?
What about secondary market for the universe? How do people offload those in their RSP?
So, in other words, what do people do if they want to sell their shares? We haven't had a lot of that yet, but of course it's early days. When it does happen, we have to be able to sell them to somebody else. So the co-op buys them back at the price that they were originally purchased for. So we've only had one person turn them in so far. And that was somebody who was actually just trying to avoid being in a conflict of interest situation. But we bought the share back in effect, and now we're going to resell it again. So that would be the arrangement. As long as we can find another buyer for the share or for the 10 shares, we can, and we've got a list of people who are waiting to buy, but right now it's not a big issue. But say we had a whole bunch of people who wanted to turn in their shares and we weren't able to find other buyers for them, that would become a problem because that money is actually going to be tied up in solar installation. So we wouldn't necessarily be able to readily access cash to pay the personnel. But if somebody else is willing to buy the share, then it's a problem. Back, and then there's all kinds of other questions here.
So do you guys pay an annual dividend, or how do you deal with the reimbursement?
We haven't paid a dividend yet, but I expect that we will in 2018. First of all, of course, your panels have to be generating revenue. And right now we've only got two sites that are generating revenue, and a third that's just coming online now. So I think 12 months from now we'll be in a much better position to pay a little dividend, and it'll get better from then on. I think what we're also going to try to, maybe from an administrative and volunteer point of view, wait until the dividend is in the $100 range before we start paying out, because otherwise you're just spending a lot of time and money cutting pretty small checks.
And so on that same note, is there anything from your legal standpoint to prohibit you from selling shares outside of Saskatoon to the rest of the province?
Nothing prohibits us from selling shares to the rest of the province. We're not allowed to sell shares outside Saskatchewan.
I have shares, and I live in Regina.
Okay. What about the installations outside of Saskatoon?
Well, we've decided not to do that. Although we might make an exception just to help a group get started, but generally speaking, just because we're living in Saskatoon, well, if you can just imagine, if you were planning a solar installation in Saskatoon here in Regina, what would your ability be to really watch over it, properly maintain it, clean the snow off it in the winter, chat with the building owners? I mean, I'm not saying some of this can't be done, by phone and remotely, but it's just so much easier if you are actually living with a solar installation.
Yeah, I guess what I'm wondering is if you have instead of creating a whole other structure and a board and go through all the legal aspects you guys went through, is there an opportunity to say partner with you guys and essentially the Regina chapter of the SES plan?
Well, that's something that we could talk about. We can also, as an alternative, help you to, you can greatly speed up the process we went through by, you know, taking a look at our bylaws and copying the ones that are helpful for you and looking at how we incorporated it into the same thing. And we can help you get set up more quickly, I guess is what I'm saying. So that's another option.